For the session today, we're trying to use as many sort of Steve Morse related pieces of equipment as we can. I've got my own Steve Morse Y2D Ernie Ball Music Man guitar here. This one's got a whammy bar on. You can see the one which has been featured in this month's magazine, which is a fixed bridge. The Y2D is very slightly different to the original Steve Morse guitar, because that had another pickup in it and the switching was slightly more complex. But this guitar was designed for Steve's work with Deep Purple. And there's a little bit more of a stripped down guitar. When we're in this position here, we have the bridge humbucker. Here, we have the bridge and the single coil. There we have the single coil. This position, I believe, is these two pickups split. And then we have the neck pickup. Moving on to what that's running into, Steve does have his own signature angle head available, but we have a Powerball 2 here, which I have to say I'm incredibly impressed with and I'm enjoying playing through, and you really can hear Steve's sound when you put these two pieces of equipment. One of the things I especially like, which I used during the solo, was the mid boost. And you can control that mid boost there. So when I was playing the riff, I had a little bit more of a sort of scooped, slightly scooped sort of modern rock sound. And then when it came to the solo, kicking in the mids really helped the solo jump out and get those harmonics, which Steve is renowned for. Now, effects wise, I'm also running an Ernie Ball volume pedal on the floor here to help me with some of the fades during the middle section of the track, where I'm kind of violining in the chords. In the effects and return of the amplifier, we're using the TC Electronics flashback delay, which is the delay unit that Steve Morse is currently using. So we've tried to, as best we can, sort of reproduce his tone for our lesson. Anyway, let's crack on now and take a look at the track, and I'm going to break it down into several sections. Basically, we have a verse riff, we have a chorus riff, we have a midsection, and then we have the solo, which is played over a slightly shorter verse and chorus section. Oh, and we also have a little intro figure just to sort of kick things off. So let's take a look at the intro figure to start with. It's basically a unison minor pentatonic figure. We're starting off on the 9th fret of the G.
Hello and welcome to iGuitar Issue 9. From the Dixie Dregs to Deep Purple, Steve Morse has carved out one of the most spectacular careers in guitar playing. Steve came into iGuitar Studio to give Jamie Humphries our world-exclusive interview. Check it out, and check out Jamie's fabulous Steve Morse style analysis, too. And if that's not enough, thanks to our good friends at Ernie Ball Music Man, one lucky iGuitar reader is going to be receiving a free Steve Morse Y2D Music Man guitar in our fantastic free entry competition. What's more, the guys at TC Electronics heard what we were doing, and they've added a TC flashback delay pedal with the Steve Morse tone print to our prize giveaway. 30 years ago, rock lost one of its shooting stars, the hugely talented Randy Rhoads. We celebrate Randy's short, stunning career with a major, previously unpublished interview from his early days with Ozzy, plus a complete career overview. You want more? We've got it. Red Beach is one half of Whitesnake's guitar duo. Recently in the UK for a rare Sewer masterclass, iGuitar's Tom Quayle took the opportunity to speak with him. Meanwhile, over at PRS, David Grissom talks to Stuart Bull about his latest, greatest PRS model, and a lot more. Our review lineup comes straight from the guitar shop in heaven. Reviews of gear from Music Man, Engel, TC Electronics, Pedal Snake, Digitech, Yamaha, Peavey, Usen Kettner, Orange, and pedal veterans Morton. All of you bassists, do not feel left out. Dan Veal meets with the amazingly talented Mr. Doug Wimbish, and then gets to review the latest Cobalt strings from Ernie Ball, plus gear from Ampeg, Breedlove, and Three Leaf Effects. Finally, to the calm waters of the Quiet Room, where we encounter two impressive new Paul Brett-designed acoustics from Vintage, a fabulous Tanglewood Sundance, and Fate's latest, the Venus. We also have a world-exclusive first look at the Vigier Excalibur fretless with Guthrie Govan. Add our exclusive tuition columns with downloadable tab, and that's iGuitar, the first interactive magazine for guitarists the world over. now bigger than ever and still completely free.